Second and eight. That's the last play, Tommy, of the third quarter. We'll take a one-minute break. We'll be back in 1 minute for the fourth quarter.
Nothing is the score. On that last tackle, Zach Greer and Todd Music for Lebanon High School. And let's see if I can set some of these guys. In the secondary, we've got Cunningham, Stone. We've got back there in the secondary, we have got Ricky Phillips at a safety spot. And Mo Thompson. Zach Greer is a linebacker. Sellers was in there for a play, and Sellers is still in there at linebacker. We've got up front at a noseman position is Charlie Lambert.
It is second down and 8 yards to go. The ball is on the seven. They take it, run it right up the middle. A little daylight this time, and Ricky Hughes knocked him down on about the 11. He had some daylight off tackle, and Hughes made a nice tackle on the 11-yard line where it'll be third down. They have to go to our, that was Ricky Phillips instead of Ricky Hughes. Ricky Phillips knocked him down on the 11-yard line.
Bruce had a stunt called on that play. We ran our strong safety, Cunningham, lined him up in the line as a down lineman and tried to blast him through across the line of scrimmage. And coming up to make the stop was Phillips.
Phillips has been holding on our extra points tonight. Damon Stone still the free safety, and Mo Thompson's the corner along with Phillips. Linebackers are Sellers and Greer. Sweep right. Outside, they cut it back in, got the first down, crossed the 15, got all the way to about the 19, close to the 20. I think they'll spot it on the 19. They run a sweep and got a first down. Their first down running the ball tonight. It's been a long time since they've had a first down. That's their third of the night. 34 to nothing, Lebanon in Warren County. Next week, we have to travel to Nashville, Tennessee, over in Hillwood, and take on Hillwood, who we beat last year here, I think, 35-3. I said, Cravens takes it, runs it off tackle, tries to get outside. Phillips is chasing him one way. He's going to cut it back the other on the 10 and gets knocked down on the 12. Ricky Phillips, the corner, played that very, very well, chased him back the other way, and Travis Brown had nowhere to go, and he lost from the 19 all the way back to the 12 for a 7-yard loss.
Once again, the Lebanon defense had Cunningham slip in there as a down lineman against that smokestack, trying to just get across the line of scrimmage and cause some problems. Tailback had nowhere to go, reversed his field, and there was Cunningham waiting for him and a pile of those blue shirts.
So it's second down and 17. Cravens is the quarterback. He's a senior. Three backs behind him. They give it to the third one, and he got hit hard by 69 of Lebanon. 69, it kicked in Tommy, and he really met him in the hole. Who you got there?
Charlie Lambert. Charlie, 6'1", 275-pound junior nose man. Charlie in there on the tackle.
Charlie was ineligible last year, too, as a freshman. And this year, he's getting some playing time tonight. Third down, ball on we'll call it the 12, 12 and a half, maybe the 13. I set. Lebanon in a 50. Oh, they're up in a 6. Hot pass over the middle, intercepted and dropped. Damon Stone, I think he was looking for a touchdown run right for that corner and maybe took his eyes off the ball. He had it zoomed in very, very well. I think he was going to run before he caught it.
John, it looked like Damon had all sorts of green grass in front of him.
He sure did, Tommy. I tell you what, he had that ball picked the whole way, and I think he was looking for 6 before he even had a good hand on it.
High snap, but it is away, straight up in the air. We better move out of the way, and I thought it was going to hit one of our guards. And it gets a pretty good roll and rolls to the 39. Actually, it hit on about the 28. Almost hit one of our people going downfield and rolled down to the 39, a 26-yard punt, and about 10 of it was a roll.
Okay, offensive tackle for Lebanon. Here comes Scott Kaiser into the football game. Willie Westmoreland checks in at a receiver position. And let's see who else as we see Coach Mark Medley clearing the bench at that offensive guard spot. Shane Thorne in at the right guard spot for Rob Pack.
Jared comes wide out here to the right. Takes the ball. They run a sweep. That's Moss. He'll cut it in. He'll get knocked down. He got two to the 30. Well, I got three to the 36, I think. 3 yard gain, Charles Moss. He's our third tailback tonight. Lanier and Neal have carried earlier. Now Moss is in. We're still going with the same quarterback triple.
Trey Reynolds in there at a guard for the Blue Devils. And at one tackle spot is John Oakley.
8 minutes to play. Lemon led it to half, 34 to nothing. That's what the score is now. They run a trap in the middle, and that's Luke Shepard running that football as he crossed the 35 and got to the 34. And there, his feet knocked out from under him. And he's going to be about 4 yards short of a first down on the 34.
Bruce, I'm talking to Zach Manier. Zach had a good game tonight.
Yes, line block real good, and Greg threw good, and we just all came together.
Hey, it's great to get a good rest in a game like this, isn't it?
Yes, it is, especially on home, so I'm ready to go dance now.
Back to
sweeped the Moss. He dropped it, picked it up, and Moss got close to the first down on the 30, and he's short of a first down. They'll put it on the 31. We've got to go to about the 29 and a half. Moss dropped the football, but it bounced right back up to him, and he was dancing himself to the 31. Garrett splits wide to the right. We're going for it. Fourth down in a yard and a half. We run a sweep to Moss. He won't get it. He'll get knocked down for a 4 yard loss back to the 33, maybe a 3 yard loss. And Warren County will take over. So Warren County has taken over. Kind of a dull second half, but it's good to see that these young guys have gotten into the ball game, a lot of them, because they've been practicing since August the 1st and have not really had a chance to play a lot, and they're getting that chance tonight.
In at a defensive end spot for the Blue Devils is Shane Woodall. Defensive tackle is Music. Charlie Lambert at the nose. The other defensive tackle is Trey Mangrum, and it looks like Moscadelli have a defensive end spot. Sellers at a linebacker.
And Warren County confused again, Tommy. And they'll take a timeout, and we will too. 34 to nothing. We'll take a 30-second break, and we'll come back.
In the fourth quarter, 6:09 to go in the football game. Lebanon on top by a score of 34 to nothing over Warren County. Next week, we go to Hillwood.
Back to pass. Gravens looking long pass down the middle. Caught, intercepted by Damont Stone. That thing was almost caught. It was tipped first, I think, by Cunningham. And then Warren County had it for a half a second, and Damont picked it off on the 39-yard line. No return. First down, Blue Devils.
Bruce, Damont has had an incredible game. He's had the punt return for a touchdown. He's had the long reception for a touchdown. Now he's intercepted a pass. Great job by Damont. His first interception of the year, if that memory serves me right, I'll check my stats, Terry. He had 8 last year.
Lebanon's got a wide slot left. That's Stonesopper, the split in. They run the trap, and Shepard almost broke it as he crossed the 40. And if he could have got away from one man, he had a lot of daylight down this side. John, he had a lot of daylight. If he got away from that man, you might want to. I see Andy Reid down there with you. I haven't seen him in a long time. You might want to interview him.
Andy's down here with me. Shepard was twisting and turning. If he'd have twisted one more time, he'd have had a lot of running room.
So he picked up about 5 anyway, maybe 6. Slot left. Take it. They run Shepard again, and they're kind of pushing and shoving in the middle. And he got to the.